Hi everyone, my name is Federico Tartarini and I'm the main author and main developer of PyThermal Comfort. In this video I just want to show you how you can get started, how you can find the documentation, how you can install the package and where you can find video tutorials, documentations and examples. So, if you want to get started with PyThermal Comfort, the best way is to visit PyPy, which is the official Python package repository, where you can actually find the installation string to install PyThermal Comfort. So if you want to install PyThermal Comfort, you just copy here, copy to clipboard, or copy this string here. Then you go into your terminal. I'm assuming for this video that you have already Python installed on your machine. And you just have to go into your terminal. So in this case, I'm going to use an IDE. So if you go into the terminal and you do pip install. So it really depends if you have Python 2 and Python 3 installed in your machine. So in my case, I have Python 3 installed and Python 2 installed on my machine. So I will have to do pip 3 and I have to do install PyThermal Comfort. You press enter. The package is very light. So as you can see, you can say collecting Python PyThermal Comfort, installing and successfully install PyThermal Comfort. So you should be able to see the same message as I see here. Maybe the version will change, so I might update the version of PyThermal Comfort in the future. So you might see a different number here, but as long as you see the successfully installed message, you are ready to go. So let's go back for a second to the PyPy. So here you have a link, so how to install it, the documentation. So if you click here, you will be redirected to this page, which is the official documentation page, which is currently hosted on ReadyDocs. And then you have also a link to examples and tutorials. Okay, so if you click on examples, you will be redirected to some examples. I've uploaded them in the GitHub repository. So just later in 1 second, I will show you the GitHub repository. So these are all examples. So if you want to calculate the PMV PPD, you, for instance, can look at the example and just copy and paste. Just click row here. You just copy and paste this code into your IDE, into a text file, whatever you prefer. And then you can compile this code and run and get the simulation and get the results. So these are just a couple of examples. Let's go back here to PyPy. Exactly. So you can also find some video tutorials and here they are. So if you look for my name, Federico Tartarini on YouTube, you will find this video as well as other videos which I've already uploaded on how to calculate PMV, SET, UTCI, and Azure Adaptive, and maybe I will add even more videos in the future on my YouTube channel. And finally, another important thing that you can find here is the change log. So if I will spot any error, if I will fix something, if I will add something to the package, I will just list it here. So keep an eye on this change log section here because it's very important, and you can see what has been changed in the package and what I've added. Finally, you can have a look at the license, which is MIT. So basically, you just can copy the code into your project and you shouldn't have any issues, and which Python version are compatible with which Python version can be used with PyThermal Comfort. In this case, you can only use Python 3, Python version, which is higher than 3.6. So let's go back to the official documentation. So here you where you can find official documentation. Again, if you want to get to the official documentation, you just click this link here, documentation, PyThermal Comfort. It's also quite simple, pythermalcomfort.readydocs.io. So if you click here, you get redirected to the official documentation, which here it is. So I've tried to cover everything in the official documentation. So again, it reminds you how to install the package, where you can find the documentation, examples, YouTube tutorials, and here there is also a link on how you can contribute to the project. Okay? So if you want to find the example. Again, you could find them from before. I've already showed you the link. Otherwise, you click here and you click on example and we'll redirect you again to the same page. Another important thing that there is in the documentation is documentation about actually all the functions. So before we couldn't see like how to use each function, but here we can actually see in detail how to use each function. So for example, I will just show you one of these one because there are many, as you can see here. So you can go here, function documentation, comfort models, PMV PPD, and you click here. So here there is an exhaustive explanation on how to use this function. So there is a brief introduction which explains what is the PMV and PPD models are, what are the results that you're going to get. And I will not go into detail in this video because this video is just an overview about the package and I want to just to show you how to use the documentation and how to get started. I've created, for example, a specific video on how to use this function. So here you have all the input parameters that you have to enter in this function with some detailed explanations. So for instance, what is BR, there is a note, there is a link on how you calculate this parameter. And it also shows you what this function returns. There are a couple of notes at the bottom and a short example. So I've tried to provide an example for every function. So you don't have to just go back here, examples, tutorials, open this tab, but you can just copy and paste this code here into your code. And you can, you're ready to go. So you're ready to go to calculate, for instance, in this case, PMV PPD. But if you want to use the adaptive model, same. So parameters that you need to input, what returns, the nodes, and a simple example. Okay. So there is also a section on how to contribute to this project. So if you want to contribute to this project, you can actually read this guide here. However, if you find any issues and you don't want to fix it yourself, you can just click on this link here. So I will show you in a second how to get to the GitHub repository. But if you want to open an issue, you just go here in the GitHub repository, issues, you open a new issue, you describe what is the problem that you found. So short title, leave a comment, and then submit a new issue. And I will try to address the issue as soon as possible. The GitHub repository, so the PyThermal Comfort is hosted under the Center of the Build Environment GitHub account. So if you go on the, so either you look online, so for instance, you could look for GitHub PyThermal Comfort. And you should be able to find, yeah, the GitHub repository, which is here. And here it is, PyThermal Comfort. If it's not at the top, you can just look for it in the search here at the top. So PyThermal Comfort, you click here, and this is the GitHub repository. So at first, it might look a bit messy and a bit with a lot of files. However, I decided to include all these files because I think are very important because, for instance, you can see that you have the read.docs. Read.docs is the file that generates the documentation. Travis is for testing. Gitignore is another file which is important to ignore some files, not to upload them here on GitHub. So, unfortunately, it looked a bit messy, but is actually a good standard of how to design a package. However, you don't really have to worry about this directory, even if it looks a bit complex, because there is only mainly one folder that you are going to be interested in if you want to look at the source code. So if you want to look at the source code, this is the only folder that is actually of interest to you. So is the source folder PyThermal Comfort. So if you click here, you can find three Python files. So specifically models contains all the models. So as we could see before, the cooling effect, the PMV model, and so forth. Another easy way to get to this point without having to navigate to the GitHub repository is to go back to the documentation, Click on the function that you are actually interested in knowing more about, so PMV PPD. You click here, and then here at the top, you will see that there is a source button. So if you click here, you'll actually see all the source code, and it's actually easier to read because you don't have to look it up in the GitHub repository, but here you have all the source code. It's exactly the same as we can see here. So for example, as you can see, this is the import and this is the cooling effect. So it's exactly the same file as you have over here, but it's actually probably a little bit easier to read. Again, the function looks a bit more maybe complex, so ignore all this part here. This part here is just to generate all the documentation that I just showed you before. Can you see there are the parameters, what it returns, the example. So just what I showed you before. And you have the code, which is actually here at the bottom. So here you can actually see the Python code that is starting, and this is actually the Python code used to calculate the PMV PPD model. Okay, so this is one thing that I wanted to show you. Another thing that I want to show you in the GitHub repository. So again, this is not maybe of interest to all of you, but I just would like to show you because I've been asked a lot about this. So the test folder. So all the functions have been tested against the reference tables in the standards. So ASHRAE, ISO, YAN standards. So if I could find a reference table or a validation table, I just use that those values to test my function. So if you look at test models, so there are two test models and test by thermal comfort. Just look at test models here. And here you will find all the values that I've actually used to test my functions. So this value is extracted from the ASHRAE, or this value, this one is extracted from, no, this is from the ASHRAE, and the previous one was from the ISO. Or you will just see, and you can just have a look at the table, and you can see which values I've used. So for instance, this one to test the ERF, and these are all the values that I've used. So if you want to check, if you want to make sure that the function is actually working and is giving the right results, just have a look at here at which table I've used, and to make sure that you can get trusted the results and the function are validated and correct. You can also find this information on my manuscript. For only the PMV and PPD, I've only tested that. So I've tested against this value. I'm planning to add more if the standard will release new tables in order to make sure that everything is fine. So here is the code just to test this. So just a thing. So all the tests have passed. So all these tests have passed. So no issues was raised. There was actually a minor difference with this value here. We are talking about just one decimal. So that's why I've just commented these few lines here at the bottom. And as you can see here, I commented the lines that doesn't pass the test, but it's just because there was a difference of the first decimal. I've actually reported this value in the paper that I published about PyThermal Comfort, and just to show that the difference is very minor. So all these tests are passing because I want to make sure that the functions are reliable and validated against the reference table in the standard. So I guess that's all for this video. Actually, last final thing, because I just showed you before and I mentioned that I would have shown you how to get there. So if you go in the center for the built environment, PyThermal Comfort, you find another folder which is called examples, and here you can find all the code to calculate PMV, PPD, cooling effect, adaptive EN. However, you don't really have to. So I prepared this file because I created videos, as I showed before. So this is that is the source code that will be actually in the link here of the video on YouTube. However, if you want to just see a simple example on how to use the function, I would probably recommend you to just go here, examples and tutorials, and function documentation, PMVBPD. You click on the function that you want, and here is the code to get you started. So then you can play with the code, you can just change your input, and so forth. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope you will find my Python package useful.